The feeling, emotion is in the present moment. Thinking is always about the past and future. Extend that, it becomes future lifetimes. Extend that to the past, it becomes past lifetimes. Now, what is it based on? A colony of cells which have organized them into a larger and larger mass called a body-mind complex as a society, and everybody is blaming in the primitive instinct called raga and desha. So who is a single self which is surviving, or a group of collective decisions being made, we have to survive? Who is the self here? Are you getting the question? No. See, the seeking is only at this organism level. Self level, there is no seeking. The self is expressing in all these.
Yeah,
but the seeker is in the expression, not in the self. No. Seeker is the expression of this organism, which is multiplied in all of this.
In fact,
Exactly. Self only. The question is, who is seeking?
Self.
So, self is one cell or multiple cells?
No, self. I am telling you, self, not
the self.
Self.
Each cell has a self reflected there?
Self, not a senior cell. Self.
So, that's what I am saying. The self is an entity which is operating through group of organs. Right? And each of them are operating at the primitive level. Raga and Desha. So now this collective decision making has already translated into fight and flight. Collective decision making has already translated into emotions. Collective decision making has translated into the past and future. So now this is where the contribution of thinking is about. How do you come out of this whole system? So then you have to go beyond thinking. Feeling, emotion and thinking, you have to go beyond that. How do you go beyond that? Raga Dvesha is driving us like mad. How do you go beyond that? Only when you understand Raga Dvesha is survival instinct. Okay? As a self, I don't have a problem of survival. I am always there. As Atma, survival is not a problem for me. So the thinking, feeling, emotions are my tools, but the tools have overtaken me, started driving me, which is the self. Instead of I driving them, they have started my master. The primitive instincts have become my master. And the entire world is run by the raga and dvesha. The highest intellect of the scientist also is driven by the lower primitive instincts. Your higher intellect, which is faculty, is ultimately serving the lower instinct. So now, we have to go beyond thinking. So the thinking is creating an idea of an individual self, is creating an idea of individual self. Extending into the past and extending into the future. Okay? Past life, past to past life. There's an identity created by thinking. But your identity is present moment. This moment you are what you are. The self is always in the eternal presence. It is not in the past, not in the future. There is nothing but past and future in the self. The past and future appeared in the self, but self itself is not in the past and future. The birth and death is not in the past self. The survival is not a question of self. So, started as a primitive instinct, it has grown into a powerful thinking engine, which is driving the survival instinct rather than going to the your nature as a self. So now, You have to learn how to transcend that thinking. How to transcend the thinking? How to go beyond the thinking?
Switch off thinking.
Stop thinking is not a solution. Okay? So this is actually what is called yoga. This again come to yoga. Yoga chitta vritti nirodha. That means stop thinking is the prescription of yoga. It is not. Okay? Vedanta doesn't accept stopping thinking is a solution. Okay? So thinking is coming from a self-identity. Use your rational mind to look at your self-identity. Look at the assumptions behind the self-identity and go beyond self-identity. When the self-identity becomes clear to you, then the core of the thinking dissolves. The root of thinking dissolves only when the self-identity is questioned, looked at by whom? By your faculty of mind which has grown now. That's why only human beings can transcend this. Up to animal level you can't, because feeling and emotions. Even human being level, unless you have reached the stage of maturity, you cannot transcend this. So, look at your assumptions. That's where we start coming into Atmavichara. Yoga and other systems are focusing on the emotions and feeling level, and jnana is focused on thinking. Now, transcending the thinking can happen looking at the self-identity. That's called Atmavichara. So, this primitive instinct, I want happiness, goes at the level of body. It's called pleasure, sensations. A pleasant cup of coffee, taste. Smell of coffee, pleasure. So, this pleasure is momentary. Most of the human beings live at the physical level where they are seeking happiness but through pleasure. The highest form of pleasure is called sex, because the skin is the largest organ of the body. Okay? The pleasure is actually in raga and dvesha. Raga has grown into pleasure. Attraction. So, the skin and the body becomes a mechanism for happiness, pleasure. And the pleasure counterpart is pain, the duality is there. Happiness has, the pleasure has a counterpart called pain. So, pleasure and pain come together. And any sensation, any pleasure derived through sense organs, body, which is actually feeling, raga and dvesha, raga. So there is a counterpart called pain, and there is a problem of addiction. So you want more of it. So one cup of coffee will give you some pleasure. The body starts learning, because these are cellular organisms. Each of them learn. The tongue cells learn now. This is good. They want more. So when you go for another cup of coffee, who is dictating your life? Coffee is being dictated by cells. So it's like a dog has a tail. The tail is wagging the head, or head is wagging the tail. Our intellect is working as subservient to the primitive instinct. So that's why the pleasure is not the solution. The pleasure is based on the physical contact. So then comes the happiness. The pleasure is based on the moment, present moment. You cannot have pleasure of tomorrow. Pleasure is now. If you drink a cup of coffee, it gives a pleasure. Now happiness comes. Happiness is a mental contact. I think of a good thing which happened in the past. So thinking is coming here now. Okay, very nice. So the body feels good. The mind feels good. So you start making a mental trip, or a mental happiness is related to mind. Now there's a possibility that you lose with reality, because physical level you have to do some work to get it. At the mental level, you don't have to work, only imagination to go. Hey, this happened. No. I didn't like this fellow. Raga and Dvesha. Translated into happiness and unhappiness at the mental level. Okay. So now, why does the happiness happen? When does the happiness come? The happiness comes when the mind becomes silent for momentarily. Suppose I want to become, I am happy drinking a cup of coffee, which is pleasure. When I put a cup of coffee in my mouth, the mind becomes silent for that moment. Other thoughts are there, I want a cup of coffee. When the mind becomes silent, the happiness of the self or atma got reflected in the mind fully. The bliss. So the mind came out of that, because now the mind is diverted to the body and happiness. So it said, I am happy drinking a cup of coffee. It didn't know there's something called self or atma. So your association is the lower, not the higher. Okay. So the intellect is working for the lower now, not for the higher. Your intellect is supposed to work for the self, but instead of that, it is working for the organism level. So this is what is called the lower life. So happiness came momentarily, but I associate happiness with coffee or meeting a friend rather than this self. So now it becomes a habit now. It becomes a vasana. I want to do it again and again. Meet my friend, I'll be happy. So now happiness is a counterpart called unhappiness. Again, you don't like unhappiness, you have a dvesha for unhappiness. So raga and dvesha is driving to next level. Because again you are unhappiness, you are uncomfortable, I don't want to be unhappy. So what do you do for the becoming unhappy? So, but what has happened, happiness and unhappiness has become so deep into you, it has become a nature of your individual consciousness, jiva. It has gone so deep. Now it has become what you call soul or individual embodied soul. So pleasure and pain and happiness and unhappiness has programmed you so deeply, your nature itself has become that. So some people are happy all the time, whatever happens I am joyful. Maybe some children. Some people are depressed, whatever happens. So earlier the pleasure and pain were momentary, happiness was based on time. Now that has become your permanent feature because it's gone deep into you. So now you get into depression, constantly worrying. So it has become a part of your soul. It has gone deep down. Now it is not made for moment. Whatever happens, I am unhappy. Whatever happens, I am depression. Or whatever happens, I am happy. So it has become soul. The joy has a counterpart called sorrow. But now happiness and unhappiness come together once in a while. Whereas joy and sorrow are long term. Somebody is joyful. Somebody is sorrowful, depressed, lifelong. So it has gone deep into the soul. Now, beyond this happiness and unhappiness, beyond the pleasure and pain, and beyond the sorrow and joy, there is something called ananda or bliss, which requires you to transcend your thinking every day, because all these problems are caused by thinking every day. The thinking has created all the problems. Thinking is working for your lower level, raga and dvesha. So now, can I direct my thinking to the self? How I can go to the self? How I can transcend my thinking to be in the self? Not by stopping thinking. Stopping thinking is dangerous because your functions get disabled. Can I get thinking which is in a what is desired and what is not desired, what is right and wrong, discriminate and come to a thinking which will take me out of the pleasure and pain, happiness and unhappiness, joy and sorrow, and help me establish in bliss or ananda which is not dependent on any circumstance? So that is actually a real spiritual challenge. Up to the pleasure plane, happiness, you can go by the thinking, feeling and emotion. That's what is called yoga. The jump is through atma vichara. So with this, we'll stop here. We'll continue in the next session. Asato ma sadgamaya tamaso ma jyotirgamaya mrityorma amritam gamaya. Om shanti shanti shanti.
Om shanti shanti shanti.
Lokah samasta sukino bhavantu. Lokah samasta sukino bhavantu. Lokah samasta sukino bhavantu. It's already 8 o'clock. If anybody has a question, quick question.